Look at Europe. I mean, look at the wealth in America or something like that. Of course, they don't see the fact that America also has political prison systems. There's a lot of falsification of reality in the media, and there is a lot of falsification of reality about Europe. Europe has its own class system and its own repressive system, and there are huge sections of the population which are disenfranchised, oppressed. And so oppression doesn't know really a cultural or a geographic boundary. It's a cross-national boundary. What brings MBS to Trump and to others in Europe, to Macron, what ties them together is the fact that they share an interest together, a fundamental interest together. This interest exists before they came into being. This interest is historical interest.
What is the interest?
This interest is basically to safeguard their wealth, safeguard the social and political relations that generate for them more of the wealth. Syria also fell into the trap that the market is going to save us. What the market has done is it pauperized Syria. It created a window of opportunity for empire to intervene and to basically almost get its biggest prize, which is the destruction of Syria. Because the biggest prize is not really to sell goods to Syria and to trade with Syria. The biggest prize is the war itself. The war itself is huge business, militarism and waste. And Russia and China have a role to play for humanity in basically rebalancing the global order.